One of the resources that I learned about at the Course Redesign Institute was an article called Campfires in Cyberspace by David Thornburg. In this article, he describes four forms of learning that have existed for centuries: campfires, watering holes, caves, and the world. And then thinks through how we could adapt those for online learning environments. So one form of learning is the campfire. And the campfire involves an expert using storytelling to engage the learner and really draw them into the material. Traditionally, this is a lecture. In my own lectures, I've been trying to make them increasingly interactive, but one of the things that draws me is that online, you can make a lecture interactive and you can build assessment right in. So I'm using Softchalk to be able to build in interactive quizzes and tools into my online lectures together with multimedia examples so that I can use storytelling in an online format to complement the engagement that I get in a classroom. Another form of learning is called a watering hole. Now, in contemporary society, that might be a little bit more like the water cooler. But in essence, everybody has to drink water. So throughout history, people have gotten together in local settings and they've talked about things that are important to them. And this is an important part of learning because human beings need to be able to take the material that they learned about through storytelling and they need to be able to engage with it on a personal level with their peers. In traditional classrooms, this might be an in-class discussion. And if you wanted to move this online, you could have an online discussion forum. In my class, I'm using a flipped lecture to be able to make the storytelling more engaging and then to be able to use classroom time where we can have more productive discussions about course material, particularly if students have had to take a quiz on the readings before they come to class. The third form of learning that Thornburg talks about is called the cave. And the cave is the idea that we all need reflective space to be able to consolidate what we've learned. We need time alone to ourselves to be able to bring material together. So in a traditional classroom, this might be a reflective journal. It might be a solitary essay that an individual writes his or herself. You can have a cave be a reflective discussion post. This is something where the learner is writing something of their own accord for their own purposes that may be shared with the professor for assessment. You could also have a nonverbal version of this if you had students prepare a photo collage where they're taking pictures of examples of things that they're learning about and putting those together in new and interesting ways to see relationships between the ideas. So the last form of learning is called the world. And the idea here is that you shouldn't just be taking in knowledge about yourself and reflecting on it or interacting with your peers around that knowledge. You should actually be using your knowledge to solve real-world problems. So in my class, I ask students to go out and look for press releases about developmental psychology research and be thinking about how real-world people are using developmental psychology research and incorporate that into their assignments. So these four forms of learning, what Thornburg called the primordial metaphors for learning in the 21st century, offer lots of possibilities for thinking through instructional design in both traditional and online classes. So play with them. Think about how the technologies that are available might help you enhance learning for the 21st century.